On August 26, 1990, Stevie Ray Vaughan boarded a helicopter outside Chicago to be flown to Wisconsin's Alpine Valley. The open-air arena was hosting a show featuring Eric Clapton, Double Trouble, Robert Cray, Buddy Guy, and Jimmy Vaughan. For the 60,000 fans who attended, it was a blues lover's dream come true.
We went there, we did those two shows, it was great. All the bands sounded great, lots of people. You know, life couldn't be any better than that.
We were really on that night. Really on.
At the end of the show, as fog settled over the crowd, the all-star lineup of guitar players returned on stage for this rousing final jam on Sweet Home Chicago.
And Stevie started playing. I'm like, God, it was like this. The first note he played was like this big bent note. It was like that. And I was just like, it sounded like bigger than the whole place.
It was Stevie's night, and I think anybody will tell you that. He was just amazing. He just played. He was like at the top of his. He was happy. He was really happy all day, and just, you know, extra happy.
After the show, Stevie said goodbye to his brother and the band. Then he grabbed an empty seat on one of the four helicopters waiting to fly the performers back to Chicago.
Guitar great Stevie Ray Vaughan was killed early this morning when a helicopter flying him out of Alpine Valley Music Theater in East Troy, Wisconsin, crashed into a fog-shrouded hill. Vaughan, who would have turned...
I looked out and the sun was coming up and I thought this... There's no way this is true. This is just, this couldn't happen. And I ran from the room. I called security and had them meet me at his room, Stevie's room. And I said, you gotta let me into this room. And they let me in, and when they opened the door, you know, I looked in and there was the bed, you know, it was turned down. There was candy on the pillow, and I was just like, I guess it's just something I'll never get over that. I'll get better about it, but I'll never get over it.
It's strange, you know, we'd done so much together. Honestly, you know, for a while I felt like, wait a minute, I was supposed to have been on there too. I was supposed to have been on there too. What happened? You know, wasn't I supposed to go too? You know, I had such confusing feelings, you know, that it was... I mean, there's really no way I can put it into words. It's just like, it totally ripped my life apart.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved.
Not in a million years could you have ever thought any of this would be possible. I thought we were going to go on like we'd always been going, you know.
Stevie Ray Vaughan died on the same day his father had 4 years earlier.
"'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear."
3 days later, back in Dallas, he was laid to rest in a grave beside his father. Thousands who knew him and who were touched by his music gathered to say goodbye.
I've met people since he died that say, I saw him, I don't even like blues music. And I saw, this one man said this, he said, I don't even really like blues music, but I don't really care for guitar playing and all that stuff. He goes, but I saw him on TV once, and he goes, when he died, he goes, I cried. He goes, I'm not even sure why.
Stevie Ray didn't believe that death was the end. Death was just when people change, he said. You can't physically see them or talk to them. They are there. For Stevie Ray Vaughan, blues was the essence of life itself. A musical tapestry of joys and sorrows, tragedy and triumph. For 35 years, he gave that music everything he had. And for as long as the blues can lend comfort in a storm, Stevie Ray Vaughan will still be out there somewhere, playing.
Hello there, my old friend. Not so long ago, it was still the end. We played outside in the pouring rain. On our way up the road, we started over. That's how it's happened, living life by the drop. No waste of time, we'll love the day. Turning up the past, there's no easier way. Time's been between us, the main's doing in. God, it's good to be here walking together, my friend. Living life by the drop. That's how it happened. Living life by the drop.